Yeah, let me tell you, boys, I got the hungries for some breakfast.
Saw it there somewhere. Cracking country fresh eggs on the grill.
Don't do that.
Hot cakes rising like the morning sun. Sausage sizzling till it's just right done.
You deserve a break today. So get up this morning and get away.
McMuffin. Hot cakes and sausage.
To McDonald's.
What's up, everybody? This is Mo Media, and welcome to the Saturday Morning Experience, where I take you into a day of life of young me. So the year we're going to is 1982. We stayed on 14th and Keith, and yeah, that's basically the hood on our particular block. It was four stores on each corner. We had a store called The Bungalow, which was a soul food restaurant, and then we had the candy store, then we had we call it the Jamaican store or whatever, and then we had the Mart Shop, which served ice cream and french fries, hamburgers. Yeah, so it was a nice little four-corner haven for a kid. Everybody was like family. We had block parties. Everybody looked out for each other. And it was just a sense of togetherness. And yeah, it was a beautiful thing. So it's Friday night, finna go grocery shopping. I love going grocery shopping with moms because grocery stores had the comic books and they had toys. And then plus I can go and pick out my cereal. I'm going to pick 1982, so I'm going with powdered donut cereal. My second choice would be cereal with that grasshopper from Disney. Superstars, stars, something, but that cereal was the bomb. Anybody remember that cereal on how it tastes and remember eating that? Leave me a comment below, but it was so delicious. So I'm gonna pick powdered donut cereal. I'm gonna give me an activity book, probably He-Man activity coloring book. Yeah, and I'll be all set. Friday night, so I want to catch Friday night videos, which came on about 11:30. So I'm gonna try to stay up, but you know, I always fall asleep. So I got up that morning and, you know, poured my cereal, my powdered donut cereal. I'll probably have about three bowls and start my tunes. So here's what the tunes that was playing in 1982. I don't think anyone watched just one channel straight through. Maybe they did, but I didn't. So I'm gonna be surfing cartoons that I like. I'm sorry if I don't fit everyone's taste. Everyone's different, you know what I'm saying? So let's check out these tunes.
Superman, Wonder Woman, Batman and Robin, Aquaman, Black Vulcan, Samurai, Apache Chief, El Dorado. Together they form the world's greatest force, dedicated to truth, peace, and justice for all mankind. These are the Super Friends.
We'll return after these messages.
Great story! An old wizard teaching kids tricks with cigarettes.
Cigarettes. I don't like the sound of that.
Up and away!
Watch me, kids. One puff and they'll soon be in my grasp.
If it's a puff you want...
It's the cocaine!
Yeah! Foiled again! One thing you can't disguise, kids, the harm cigarettes do to you. That's why I never say yes to a cigarette.
Introducing Superman Peanut Butter. Made from top quality peanuts through and through for a nutritious taste your whole family will really eat up.
All right.
No one can resist its unbeatable protein-packed flavor. New Superman Peanut Butter. Now landing at your favorite grocery store. At last, a peanut butter you can look up to.
We see an unknown alien navigating through space. He releases three villains from Krypton, They force him to take them to 1950s Earth so they can kill Superboy.
Logar, take care of that green freak!
They attack Superboy, but somehow Green Lantern and Superman shows up to save the day.
Did you find us back in the past?
Simple. I told Superman you were looking for him.
Have a nice trip back to the Phantom Zone.
I'll see you in the future.
I wonder what he meant by that.
We'll return after these messages.
The Legoland Beta 1 command base. You build it for action. You can pretend the radar sounds an alert, a signal to the crew. So you slide them to the launch pad for a make-believe rescue. And how about the new mobile rocket transport? You can drive it over make-believe craters, then get ready for flight. You can lower the rocket, pretend to fire, and blast it out of sight.
The action's up to you.
The new Legoland mobile rocket transport from the Legoland Collection. Legoland Beta 1 command base sold separately from LEGO Systems.
Tempt my tummy. The taste of nuts and honey.
It's the honey of an O. It's Honey Nut Cheerios.
The Honey Nut Cheerios bee.
It's the taste of golden honey with a crunch that's kind of nutty. It's the honey of an O. It's Honey Nut Cheerios.
Mmm. And it's a tasty part of this good, nutritious breakfast.
Oh, it's the honey of an O. Oh, oh.
It's Honey Nut Cheerios. Oh.
We see two guys bullying a kid in front of his girlfriend. Embarrassed, he walks away. Batman and Robin saves two window washers. Batman's belt falls off due to the panicking worker. The kid finds the belt and returns to attack the bullies.
Ernie, stop!
No! What have I done?
Help! Help!
Sounds like trouble. Come on!
Using my bat devices to destroy property and frightening people isn't what makes me tough. It's believing in myself.
Batman's right. I'm not a wimp, Benny, because I'm tough enough to admit when I'm wrong.
I think I'm gonna go with the Shark Tales. Now, for those who don't know, Shark Tales are little anamorphic beings that stay in this tree at a park. But they wear these shirts that spell out they thoughts. So that's why they Shark Tales. You know what I'm saying? They're secretly crime fighters that work for the commissioner, but the park ranger who tends to them, or I don't know what he does. He likes to bother them and. But I think he cool with him, Mr. Dinkle. Yeah, and basically that's the whole idea of Shark Tales.
Hi, Shark Tales. This is Bogey. Here are some of today's exciting adventures.
Thank you.
The Shirt Tales will return after these messages.
He-Man.
Who's the big guy with the muscles?
He's He-Man, the most powerful man in the universe.
Skeletor is his enemy.
He-Man.
If He-Man, Skeletor, and Castle Grayskull, you have to put the castle together.
You're doomed, He-Man.
Oh, yeah? Watch this action, Dad.
He-Man.
Now I have the power.
He-Man and Skeletor each sold separately. Castle Grayskull also sold separately from the Masters of the Universe collection from Mattel.
It's the most popular Saturday morning show in America.
Hey!
As the Smurfs continue to face... Then it's the Gary Coleman Show.
Goodness, I need your help. As if I haven't enough problems trying to uncover a gold smuggling ring in the city. Now there are problems at the city museum. A suit of armor mysteriously got up and marched out of the museum.
A suit of armor?
Depend on us, Commissioner. Okay, gang. Now we're gonna trace the path taken by the suit of armor when it left. Here. I'll help dust you off, Pammy.
Oh, thank you, Rick. Wait, this isn't dust.
You're right. It's flecks of gold.
Gold?
Look like he snorted too much of that gold dust.
A gold detector indicates a path under that old spooky house ahead.
You mean that scary old spooky house?
Hey, look. Oops!
And they think they can keep Mr. Gold from bringing gold into the country.
Hey, I've got it. Mr. Gold is the gold smuggler. That suit of armor was made of gold.
Heads up!
What a whacked out bunch.
The Shirt Tales will return after these messages.
Boom, 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 nerf boomerang. Boom, 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 nerf boomerang. Nerf boomerang, nerf boomerang.
Easy throwing high or low. It comes back with each good throw.
Boomerang.
You can throw it by yourself. Or throw it with some friends. Nerf boomerang is safe, soft fun that never, never ends.
Nerf boomerang.
Nerf boomerang from Parker Brothers.
There's only one.
Drink in the take-along pouch. 10% fruit juice, nothing artificial.
There's only one Capri Sun. It's great tasting fun when you punch open one.
There's only one Capri Sun.
For my favorite nephew.
Wow, Shirt Tales.
Be right back.
Hey, you know who I am?
Rick Raccoon from the Shirt Tales.
Right, and this is a hearty Shirt Tales adventure meal. Hamburger, fries, and a soft drink. Look in here. There's a Shirt Tales adventure inside. Take the magic motion decoder and find the ghost.
Wow, I found it.
Good. Oops, close it up. Here he comes.
Okay, so long.
Who are you talking to?
Rick.
Rick?
Your child can collect all five Shirt Tales adventure meals at Hardee's. A new one every week.
Speedy, I've got a circus to run.
You won't have one long without a star, Mr. Crumpling.
Ta-da!
Terrific, way to go.
Flying Panda Bear in captivity. I'll make her a star and me a fortune.
Alert, Shirt Tails. Hemi's been kidnapped. Let's hit him.
I don't know. We got some abuse going on here.
For the show, we'll use this.
We get in the act, too.
She's falling. Now!
The Shirt Tales will return after these messages.
Hey, Keebler, how's the old elfin magic?
Oh, pretty good.
Ah, the old fudge-in-one side trick, huh? Wow, stripes!
Yes, sir. We're making our fudge stripe cookies. We take crisp shortbread cookies, cover them with rich fudge on one side, and fudge stripes on the other side.
Unbelievable! I always wanted to know how you elves got the stripes on your fudge stripe cookies, and I still don't know.
Keebler fudge stripes, fudge sticks, and deluxe Grahams.
If you haven't tried Kellogg's Honey and Nut Corn Flakes cereal, you've never tasted
nuts and corn. Well, I pour something sunny in my bowl each morning. Chunky nuts and honey on flakes of corn. It tastes so good, it makes me want to crow. Nuts and corn, let everybody know. Nuts and corn.
Real chunky nuts.
Nuts and corn.
With a tasty touch of honey, so the nuts stay put.
Kellogg's Honey and Nut Corn Flakes. It's the only nutty corn flake anyone makes. Nuts and corn.
What y'all think? Like the Shirt Tales? I kind of liked them when I was little. It was straight something to watch. It was cool. Next we got the Smurfs. Y'all know what the Smurfs is? Little blue creatures that be in the grass and stuff. And this evil wizard Gargamel wants to get them because you can turn them into gold.
Breakfast. Waffalo cereal. Maple flavor and blueberry flavor.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a
penny racers.
20 zany looking cars you can collect. 6 of them glow in the dark. Each sold separately.
That's penny racers.
Sun Devil and Grizzly Gasser. Penny for each car not included.
Penny racers.
Classy cars you can race and chase. F1 Dragon and Moon Van glow in the dark. Penny Racers, Sun Devil, Grizzly Gasser, F1 Dragon, and Moon Van, each sold separately from Takara.
We now return to the Smurfs.
I must find those miserable little Smurfs, Azrael. Find them and rid the forest of their nasty, rotten, wretched little blue hides once and for all. Ah!
creation of my sheer genius works, as it sure does, Rial, I'll be able to find those horrible little Smurfs with no problem. It's ready, Azrael! Now I'll find out exactly where those Smurfs are. Show me, oh magic crystal ball, where to find the most miserable creatures of all. What's this? No, I mean the Smurfs. Ah, their village. But where are the Smurfs?
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy Smurf Day, dear Dreamy! Happy Smurf Day to you!
Yay!
I hate Smurf Days.
Not yet, Dreamy.
Make a wish and blow out the candles, Dreamy.
My wish? I wish I could fly to a new world no Smurf has ever seen. Yay! Here I go! Flying to a strange new world! Ugh, I'd smurf anything in the whole wide world to be a space traveler! Ugh, I got it! Now all I need is a smurfy wind and...
Crystal ball. It's safe. It's safe.
Hit it, Harmony! Oh, sorry. Hear ye! Excuse me. This is a Smurf boy. Astro Smurf announces the unveiling of his new flying ship. All Smurfs are invited to watch his Smurf Day wish come true when he Smurfs off to the stars. I'm sorry.
Smurf?
Well,
It's a very Smurfy flying ship, Astro Smurf. But how does it work?
Pedal power, Papa Smurf. Pedals turn the propeller, which lifts the ship into the air and Smurfs beat to the stars.
Hey, space waste. I predict it will never work. Never, never, never.
Oh, Smurf up your face, me no brainy.
Well, good luck, Astro Smurf. Have a safe trip.
Goodbye. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Smurf off!
Yep, this is a real nice breeze.
Yeah, this is real. Wait a minute. I hate nice breezes.
Faster! Faster!
See? I was right. I was right.
I was right. I was right. Oh, poor Dreamy. His little blue heart is broken.
Astro Smurf has hitched his wagon to a Smurf, and he'll never be happy until he can fly to the stars. But alas, it can never be.
But that was his Smurf Day wish.
Oh, yeah! And all Smurf Day wishes come true, don't they, Papa Smurf? Yes, that's been the way of the Smurfs for as long as I can remember.
Which is exactly 543 years, right, Papa Smurf?
Papa Smurf, we have to do something to make his wish come true.
Yes, Smurfette. And I have an idea that might work.
Your relictor washer will work now, Papa Smurf?
Handy Smurf checked it over and fixed everything that was wrong.
And I can Smurf off of the stars right now?
Yes, but first you must take the special raspberry potion that will give you strength on your long journey. The propeller's turning. Send up the smoke clouds and start rocking the ship!
Tell me, Clumsy, where were you when brains were handed out?
Where was I? I don't know. Maybe I was with you, huh, Brain?
I hate smoke!
My ship's moving! I'm Smurfed off! I'm on my way to the star! What's going on? I feel so sleepy. Must be the altitude. Oh, I mustn't.
It stopped. He's asleep. The raspberry potion worked. Hurry, get Astro Smurf out of there and let's take the ship apart.
It's all apart, Papa Smurf. What do we do with the pieces?
Tomorrow, we take them to a secret spot whose whereabouts only I, Smurf.
Oh, goody Smurf drop. I love secret
spots. Add 4 grains of euphoria with the boiling juice of the mandrake root. Now to try it out. Oh, the formula works! The Smurfs can only see me now!
There they are again, Asriel. Don't they look good enough to eat? Come on, we won't lose them this time!
Is it much further, Papa Smurf?
Not far now.
Oh my, how much further, Papa Smurf?
Not far now.
This isn't funny! How much further, Papa Smurf?
Not far now.
Is it much further, Papa Smurf?
Yes, it is!
But there's nothing but a volcano, Papa Smurf.
And you always said volcano Smurf, fire and smoke, and all kinds of terrible and nasty things.
True, true. But this volcano is extinct.
Oh, of course! Extincted.
Come on, let's get this Smurf on the road. We have work to do.
Those miserable, rotten, disgusting Smurfs crossed here, Asriel. Look at their revolting little footprints. Come on, they're within our grasp now. Come on, Asriel.
Meow!
No! miserable cat, Azrael! How dare you!
No!
One of these days, Azrael, I'm going to turn you into a cat fur pillow!
Why do we have to smurf our brains out while sleeping Astro Smurf here sleeps? This is for the Smurfs.
Wait a second, Grouchy! You know what's green, red, yellow, with big eyes and long teeth?
No, what?
I don't know either, but it's crawling up your hat!
I hate bugs!
Show me your magic crystal ball. Where are the most disgusting creatures of all? So, they're inside your volcano. That's not far from here. And it's the perfect spot to finally put an end to those miserable little creatures.
At least for now.
The Smurfs will return after these messages.
It's the Bubble Yum Sweepstakes. Millions will enter to win the grand prize weekend for four at any Six Flags park. The roller coaster is a quiet ride! The funhouse is relaxing! The water ride is pleasant, too.
Thousands of other great prizes. To enter, send two wrappers or the words Bubble Yum Bubblegum to Box 2705, Westbury, New York, 11591.
I love the crunchy wheat taste of Kellogg's Mini Wheats, but the frosting side agrees with the little kid in me.
The whole grain shredded wheat side to me is quite superior. The light frosting pleases my girlish interior.
Kellogg's Mini Wheat Cereals. Whole grain shredded wheat for the adult in you, light frosting for the kid in you.
For me, the manly side of Mini Wheats is fitting, but the frosting's good too.
And I'm not kidding.
Watch out, Star Raider. You're flying in the Atari galaxy. We play rough out here. Sure, you have an attack computer and photon torpedoes. Ooh, nice shot, Flyboy. But there's 40 of us, only one of you. Checking the map, Star Raider? We know where you are. Bye-bye, Star Raider.
Star Raiders, the home video game that's only from Atari and only for systems from Atari.
We now return to the Smurfs.
When Astro Smurf wakens, he'll think he's on another planet, and we want to be ready, so that's why I smurf this magical potion that will turn us all into Smurfs.
Smurfs? What's a Smurf, Papa Smurf?
I'll show you, Bumsy. This is a Smurf. I'm Grandpa Smurf.
Where am I? Oh, I'm on another planet. This is Smurf-tastic. Here he comes, Clumsy.
Oh, yeah, and look at him. He really thinks he's on another planet. Yep, boy, is he dumb. I wonder where he was when the beans were handed out.
Not beans, Clumsy, brains.
Oh, yeah, well, that's what I meant. Bean brain, yep.
Wonder if anyone lives here. Guess that answers that. Hi-ya! Me, friend, I'm in big ship. Room! 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 Come meet Grandpa Smurf, king of all Smurfs!
Say, could you unhook my shorts first? That would be nice. Yep.
Where you come from?
From a planet called Earth, Grandpa Smurf.
Your friend or foe?
Oh, big friend! Big friend!
Then, we have council meeting and consider this. Stay here.
Oh, I wonder what you're going to do to me!
Me. We're almost there, Azrael. We're almost there.
Gargamel, we'd better tell Papa.
Yeah, and is he gonna be mad?
Smurf, we have reached a decision.
Oh?
We decide you are friend. Welcome to Planet Smurf.
Oh, thanks,
Scrap or Swoop?
Prepare feast to honor Astro Smurf.
Yay!
Boy, this sure is Smurfy, Grandpa Swoop. I'm having a great time.
You sleep soon. Need plenty strength to fly back to home planet tomorrow.
Oh, but I'm never gonna fly back to Earth. I wanna stay here forever.
Forever? But you must go.
Grandpa Smooth! Grandpa Smooth!
Where? Guard! Take Astro Smurf to hut and don't let him out of sight. Gargamel is here. Astro Smurf mustn't see him or he'll know he's still on Earth. But that's only half our worries. Astro Smurf likes the planet so much, he wants to stay here forever. I must think of a plan.
I know they're nearby, Azrael. I can smell them. I can feel them. Let me see. What's this? Those aren't Smurfs.
How Gargamel found us, I don't know. But I think he's about to feel a bit under the weather.
Yow! My crystal ball! It's destroyed! Now I'll never find the Smurfs! Slimy lizard tongues! My seat is burnt to a crisp, I'm soaking wet, and my crystal ball is shattered. What else can go wrong? Something tells me Papa Smurf is behind this, Azrael. Azrael, get off my face! You mangy bag of fur! Let's get out of here! Ouch!
Now, to become Smurf, you must prove courage and skill.
Okay, but what do I have to Smurf?
After we spin you around, you must Smurf spear right into that bullseye.
What bullseye? I can't see a thing.
It is the way of the Smurf. Test ready. And for second test, Astro Smurf, you must climb pole.
I've Smurfed taller in my time.
It'll take months and years to Smurf that grease pole.
Yeah, that's right. A zillion years.
I hate greased poles.
Here I am.
Huh?
He's a Smurf.
Hello, this pole isn't even greased.
Isn't greased? Clumsy!
I thought Greedy was gonna do that! Yup, I did!
Me? I thought Grouchy Smurfed the pole!
Lazy was gonna do it!
You must now swim across lake.
Okay! I'm a good swimmer!
Carrying that rock!
That rock? But that's absolutely smurfly impossible!
Too bad.
Ooh, say, you look familiar. Haven't I seen you someplace before?
Who, me, dear sir? No, I was just...
I'm wasting. You want to be Smurf? You swim across the lake with rock.
Huh? Well, this is gonna be easy.
Hey, is this some kind of a joke?
That rock!
It's floating!
No wonder! It's pumice stone! There is one final test, Astro Smurf.
I'm ready!
You must prove you can live harsh life of Smurfs. You must cook all meals, wash dishes, sweep, clean, and scrub.
And you must kneel in respect before every Smurf you meet.
And kiss his beautiful feet.
But, and all you can eat is wild grass.
And you can never whistle or sing.
No matter how happy you are.
And no holidays, including Smurfmas and St. Smurfentine's Day.
So, you must do all these things to be Smurf.
Well, on second thought, maybe I'd better be Smurfing back to Earth.
Ah.
What's going on? I feel so sleepy. Oh, I mustn't.
He's asleep. A raspberry potion's working again. We better smurf to it.
Oh, goody. There is nothing like a smurf. Nothing in the world.
I hate this.
Oh, how much farther, Pop Smurf?
Oh, smurf up!
Where am I? To a planet inhabited by spoofs.
Spoofs? Well, I never.
They wanted me to stay, but I was feeling homesick, so I came back.
You're not thinking of flying away again, are you?
Well, the thought of flying to other planets is tempting, but I'll never be as happy as I am here. There's no place like home.
Ah. Yo! This is Papa Smurf's handiwork. But he'll pay for it! He'll pay double!
At least for now!
The Smurfs will return after these messages.
Sail away, go Hawaiian! Paddle away, Hawaiian Punch, sail away!
Nothing tastes like Hawaiian Punch!
You only have to taste it once!
Taste of a place!
Ooh,
America, demand your MTV. I want my MTV.
I want my MTV.
I want my MTV.
MTV Music Television. Video music, 24 hours a day, and it's stereo.
Call your cable company and say, I want my MTV.
Return to the Smurfs.
Now we going with the Gary Coleman Show. I never watched this when I was little. So here we go, the Gary Coleman Show.
Oh, that Andy LeBeau. How does his halo yet? Just watch today's episode.
Meet Andy LeBeau, brand new apprentice guardian angel. It's his job to watch over a very special gang of kids. And that's Angelica. It's her job to watch over Andy and make sure he doesn't goof up. Of course, none of Andy's good friends down in Oakville know that he's really an angel. They just think he's one of the gang. This is Hornswoggle. He just loves getting Andy into trouble with all his dirty tricks. But don't worry, Andy can handle Hornswoggle. So, hang on to your halos. It's the Gary Coleman Show.
The Gary Coleman Show will return after these messages.
Real milk chocolate, I love that Hershey bar.
Hershey is...
That's
return to the Gary Goldman Show.
Boy, nothing like getting to work early. Ah, gives you a lot more time to play. Hi, Angie.
LeBeau, may I ask why you aren't on the job?
You don't think I'm enjoying this, do you?
Need you ask?
I'm working real hard. I'm doing an early morning safety inspection of the playground stuff.
It's safe. You aren't. And another thing, LeBeau.
Two points.
I, on the other hand, only have one point to make. Get to work.
Okay, Angie. I'm on my... Oops, I forgot. Time's wasting. Gotta get to work.
LeBeau! Someday you'll have recruits of your own to break in, and I hope they're all like you.
Recruits of his own to break in, eh? Little does Angelica know, she's given me a wonderfully wicked idea.
And to think I got up early today.
Good morning, Mr. LeBeau. Sir?
Hornswoggle. Some days it doesn't pay to get up at all.
But wait. I know we've had our little differences in the past.
Little? Are you kidding?
Listen, I've had it with the bad life. I want to make good for all the evil I've caused. I want to straighten out, fly right, earn my wings. I need your help.
That's a bit hard to swaggle, Hornswallow.
I know what you mean, but think how reforming a bad egg like me would impress Angelica.
I gotta admit, he's got a point there. Okay, it's a deal. I'll show you the ropes, but no tricks.
Oh, of course, no tricks. Thank you. Thank you.
Now, the first thing you gotta do as a new recruit is keep your eyes open for trouble.
Trouble? Uh-huh. Check. Got it.
And speaking of trouble, look there. I bet you Mac's just itching to dunk that paint all over poor Hagrid.
Oh, mercy. How vile. Recruit Hornswaggle requesting permission to stop bad deed in progress, sir.
Yeah, right on. Go to it. You weren't supposed to stop him that way. Get that can off his head.
Oh, certainly. Whatever you say. All right. Who did it?
Huh? Morning, Mac.
The ball.
You don't want to do anything I'll be sorry for, do you? Especially in front of a witness.
But Andy, my boy, Mac can't see me. Sorry about that.
How about we have a real civilized talk about this? Yikes! Sounds like it'll be a pretty one-sided conversation.
Mr. LeBeau, yoo-hoo, where are you?
Is he gone?
I must apologize for my awkward handling of that problem. Doing good deeds is new to me.
Well, okay, but let's try to be more careful.
Oh, I will. I will. What's that?
Sounds like Bartholomew is helping Lydia. Better check it out.
Lydia, here's the ice for your party.
Thank you, Bartholomew, dear. Put it in the shade, will you?
What you up to, Bartholomew?
Oh, hi, Andy. I'm helping Lydia get ready for a garden party.
Look at all the goodies. Sure wish I was going.
So do I.
What? You mean you're doing all the work and Lydia didn't invite you?
Well, I guess so, yeah.
Oh, Bartholomew, as soon as you finish chatting, we will have all the chairs to set up. Did she say we?
Sure, right away, Lydia.
Oh, and bring me some lemonade from the kitchen, please.
Sometimes Lydia really takes advantage of him. I think Bartholomew could use a little help.
Oh, let me do it. I'll do it. Oh, silly me. I just got carried away.
Not to mention Lydia.
Oh, no, Lydia, what happened?
Andy LeBeau, that's what happened. He pushed me in.
But I didn't...
And just look at my exclusive designer dress.
I don't suppose it's drip dry.
How dare you suggest such a thing?
Yeah, I didn't think so.
Sorry. My fault entirely. Here's a towel.
Give me that! Oh, that does it! Ow!
You can come out now. She's gone.
Oh, go away. I had less trouble when you were bad.
Give me one more chance, please. Please.
Now I know what Angelica goes through.
I know I can make good. Honest.
Why me? Why me?
If my calculations are correct, this device should accurately record the alterations in atmospheric pressure.
Could you say that again in English?
As I said, it'll tell us what weather to expect. Now, if we only had some wind to carry it higher aloft...
Hear that? It's good deed time. Whip up a little breeze for Spence.
A breeze? I should be able to handle that.
Yay!
Hey, not bad. There might be hope for you yet. Andy! Hi, Sugar. What's happening, guys?
I'm doing a barometer reading, Andy. Thanks to this calm, even breeze, I can tell we're in for beautiful weather.
You're in for more weather than you believe, kiddo.
There would appear to be some error in my forecast.
Yeah, and the error's name is Hornswoggle.
If that's your idea of a breeze, I'm glad I didn't ask you for wind. Knock it off!
Sorry. I can only start storms, not stop them. Why don't you show me how?
But they'll see me.
Tisk, tisk. What a darn shame.
So that's it. I should have known.
May I have your halo? Soon you won't have any use for it. And I'd like to start a collection.
You want my halo? Try and catch.
Yikes! What a mess!
True, but it does afford protection from the elements.
Now I'll show you how it's done. There, how about that?
Hey, nice going, teacher. Couldn't have done it better myself.
Shucks, I knew I should have spent more time on that chapter. Well, no time like the present. Let's see. Levitating, disappearing, walking through walls. Ah, here it is. Storm stopping made easy.
Sometimes, Big Brother, I wished you liked simple things. Baseball, tap dancing.
I must admit, I'm rather puzzled by the turn of events.
After you practiced on this simple stuff, LeBeau, I'll give you some tests on floods, typhoons, and hurricanes!
Okay, let's see now. One spin to the left. Half a turn to the right. And one big jump backwards, and bingo!
Sloppy, you good, sloppy. You forgot this whole patch of storm.
I didn't forget. I saved it just for you. Bon voyage.
Hey, the storm's over.
I shall have to check out this mechanism.
Want to join us for lunch, Cupcake?
Thanks, but I gotta go take care of something.
Yes, LeBeau?
Here, Angelica. These are all for you.
Okay, LeBeau. Out with it. Now, what have you done?
Nothing. Just wanted to tell you I know what you go through with me.
Really? You do? Good, LeBeau. With that kind of attitude, it won't be long before you're training recruits of your own.
Well, I hope not.
The Gary Coleman Show will return after these messages.
A fun factory. Let's have a Play-Doh party.
Yeah.
A shooting star.
You can make all sorts of great things with a Play-Doh Fun Factory.
I made spaghetti.
And now you can get a Frogger Fun Kit free when you buy a Fun Factory in specially marked packages. It's got a Frogger poster, decals, t-shirt iron-on, puzzles and games, while supplies last. The Play-Doh Fun Factory toy comes with everything you see here. From Kenner.
Uh-oh, the kids are after me Lucky Charms. Whoops! I'd make a balloon and take off with me crunchy oat cereal with marshmallow surprises. Pink hearts, yellow moons, orange stars, green clovers, and blue diamonds.
Sounds perfectly delicious.
Yikes!
Where are your Lucky Charms?
Right here, my friends. They're part of this good, nutritious breakfast.
Frosted Lucky Charms!
They're magically delicious.
They're magically delicious!
We now return to the Gary Coleman Show.
It's Lookout LeBeau reporting for duty.
These old glasses from Angel Surplus are super.
That's the gang.
I wonder what they're doing. And there's Mrs. Trindle. Looks like something's up. One thing that's up is you, LeBeau. Why aren't you down in Oakville?
I was just looking for trouble, Angie.
So what else is new? May I suggest you go looking for trouble in person?
You got it.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Have some more cookies, everybody.
I hope everybody includes me.
Well, boy, these are good. Yeah, they're great. Thanks.
Cookies, here I come.
Well, hi, Andy. What brings you here?
The heavenly scent of Mrs. Trindle's cookies. What else?
Don't be shy. Have some more.
I'm trying real hard not to be shy.
Why, Mrs. Trindle, is something the matter?
Oh, it's nothing.
We want to help.
Please tell us. Come on, out with it.
Well, all right. I just bought this beautiful little dream house in the country, and now I don't have enough money to pay for moving expenses.
Is that all? I can pay your moving expenses out of my allowance.
Yeah, she's loaded.
Oh, no, I wouldn't accept charity.
Nothing to it. I'll just levitate all her stuff to the new house.
No, you won't, LeBeau. How would you explain tables and chairs and dishes flying over Oakville?
Well, we could say it was a freak wind. I think I've just been shot down.
I got it! Let's move Mrs. Trindle ourselves!
Why didn't you think of that, Mr. Guardian Angel?
It was like this. He took the words right out of my mouth.
Gee, Mrs. Trindle, I didn't know your building was so, No, tall! Lydia, what floor is Mrs. Trindle's apartment on?
The very top, what I like to refer to as the penthouse.
That's what I was afraid you were gonna say.
What motivated the appearance of that moving truck?
Yeah, and besides that, where'd he come from?
He came from my allowance, silly.
But Mrs. Trendle said...
Do we wait for a high wind to carry the furniture?
See, Angie? Someone else thought of it, too.
Well, if it isn't the little do-gooder.
Hornswoggle, you're the moving man.
You guessed it, kiddo, and I'm going to make sure this is a very moving experience for you.
I didn't have to look for trouble. It came to me.
At what point should we commence?
How about the piano?
This object appears quite substantial. Let's find out. The mass equals half the square of the total weight times the gravitational pull.
Well, what does all that mean?
The piano is heavy.
In that case, let's share the work. You take the piano and I'll take the stool.
Maintain a firm grasp.
If you mean hang on, I'm with you.
If you think I'm gonna let you make trouble for the kids, I'm gonna...
Help!
It would appear the kids are doing my job for me.
Yipes!
Yes, you might say that.
Not exactly the kind of moving job I had in mind.
Gee, I didn't know you were that strong.
Actually, I'm not.
The Gary Coleman Show will return after these messages.
Kellogg's Talking Krispies present Barney.
Why so blue, Barney?
Kids don't want colorful balloons on a rainy day.
You look so... deflated. One of our crispy cereals might help. Let's see. Marshmallow Krispies. Perfect.
Hey, bright colored marshmallows.
It's fun to put life frosted
cocoa
marshmallow
into your morning.
Part of this complete breakfast.
With Barney around, who needs rainbows?
We now return to the Gary Coleman Show.
Oh, I do love canaries. They're so golden.
Bye-bye, birdie.
Oh, heavens! Help! Mrs. Trindle's canary is loose.
Yeah, and I'll bet I know the buzzard who's responsible. Good time to practice a little mental control. I wonder how I'll make out with a bird brain.
Well, at least you're evenly matched. Sorry, LeBeau. Couldn't resist that straight line.
Speaking of straight lines, watch this.
Oh, what will I tell Mrs. Trendle? Maybe I could buy her a pet shop.
Save your money, Lydia. In you go.
However did you catch it, Andy?
It was nothing. I know how to handle things with wings.
Gee, look at all this heavy stuff. We still gotta move.
We may have overestimated our physical capabilities.
Yeah, and we bit off more than we can chew besides.
Speaking of chewing, why don't we take a luncheon break? My treat, of course.
Yes, maybe some nourishment will revive us.
I sure hope so, or we're really gonna let Mrs. Trindle down.
I'll stick around and keep an eye on things.
Looks like your friends are chickening out. They'll never finish.
Oh, yeah? We'll be back.
But I'm gonna move all this stuff before they get back.
How about that?
Impossible, especially with me around to stop you.
Well, watch this.
Having a bit of trouble, are we?
Must be a short circuit in my halo.
I don't even have to do anything. You do-gooders are all weaklings.
I suppose you could do better.
With one ear tied behind my back? Watch.
Okay, so you got it off the floor. Let's see you move it.
Nothing to it for one with my talent. Satisfied, puny one?
Well, it was all right. One little piano.
You, that's mere child's play. Observe. Two at a time. I could do this all day.
Wow. Gee, you think I could learn how to do that?
Typical. If you want a job done right, you have to do it yourself.
Wow, great! And without a scratch, too!
Years of practice, do-gooder. Years of practice. There. A job well done.
Not quite. I still gotta load it all in the truck.
You? At that rate, we'd be here till next week. I'll handle it. There! Completed in record time.
Hey, look! Everything's loaded!
Why, thank you so much, Andy. But how?
Don't thank me. Thank him.
Golly, thanks, mister.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Oh, gee, it was nothing.
And I never could have moved here without all your help. Thank you all.
You're welcome.
You see, you do-gooders would never have gotten that job done without me.
Right, Hornswoggle? You didn't do bad at all.
Bad? I didn't do bad? That's right. Wait a minute. What? I've been hornswoggled. How embarrassing. Outmaneuvered by that doggone do-gooder. One of these days I'll make the right move. Then I'll hornswoggle the world.
Well, LeBeau, I see Mrs. Trindle is moved in.
Yep, and Hornswoggle is sure put out.
The Gary Coleman Show will return after these messages.
You're in the big leagues when you make a perfect slide. You're in the big leagues when you keep the team alive. You're in the big leagues when you block a shot or two. You're in the big leagues when you're in the big league chew.
Big league chew. Man-sized wads of great-tasting shredded bubble gum stuffed into a giant Stay Fresh pouch. For big league flavor and big league bubbles, it's big league chew.
You're in the big leagues when you're in the big league chew.
Know what we like best about your kingdom of half?
Has to be the half-day school.
This is even better.
Then it's Halvesies, my crunchy, sweet new corn and rice cereal.
But half the sugar of most sugar-coated cereals.
How does it taste so sweet?
That's my secret. It's Legree. Now what?
Half a car.
I'm halfway there.
Half a bridge.
Whoa! Nice work, kids. New Halvesies are a crunchy, sweet part of this balanced breakfast.
Thank you.
on Different Strokes. It's a slam-bang comedy as Arnold falls in love. Then on Silver Spoons, Ricky goes ape when he befriends an orangutan. Tomorrow night, don't miss the heartwarming special, Grandpa, Will You Run With Me?, starring Dorothy Hamill, Eric Estrada, Andy Gibb, and more.
Hi, my name is RJ Caldwell, and I'm from Norwell, Massachusetts.
RJ's question on Ask NBC News in a moment.
New strawberry honeycomb is gonna score big.
Strawberry honeycomb, here it comes. Wow. Big strawberry taste, big honeycomb fun.
A giant strawberry! What's going on?
Big strawberry news from Honeycomb. Natural strawberry flavor.
Strawberry! Outstanding crunch!
Big strawberry taste, big honeycomb fun.
New strawberry honeycomb cereal, part of this nutritious breakfast.
How do you get a court case into the Supreme Court?
I'm Carl Stern, NBC News Supreme Court correspondent. There are several ways cases get to the Supreme Court. For example, the Constitution says the court has to hear cases when states are suing each other, let's say over where the dividing line is between one state and another. In most other cases, the court can choose whether to hear them or not. Most of these involve appeals from state courts or lower federal courts in which the party that lost wants the Supreme Court to change the result or to throw out a criminal conviction. About 5,000 such cases are filed every year. But the court has time only to hear about 150, the ones that justices think are most important. So while anyone can take a case all the way to the Supreme Court, the court will hear only a very few. The fact that the court didn't take a case doesn't mean it necessarily agrees that justice was done, but there's only a limited amount of time to hear cases.
New telescope, Grimace?
Yeah, it brings far away things close up.
They only look close, Grimace. Look at that McDonald's way over there.
It's close.
No, it only looks close. Now, here's another surprise.
Join the McDonald's French Fry Fan Club and get this membership card free. And look, you could win this wagon.
It's the French Fry Guys.
The French Fry Fan Club at McDonald's.
All right, now we're getting high. We're getting high. We got the Incredible Hulk and Spider-Man. Yeah.
Incredible Hulk and the Amazing Spider-Man will return after these messages.
This boy is beginning to slow down. Why did he run out of energy so soon? He didn't fuel up.
What?
With a good breakfast.
Mm. Cheerios!
Like this good, nutritious breakfast with toast, juice, milk, and tasty Cheerios, which has almost no sugar. When you fuel up in the morning with a Cheerios breakfast,
it'll really keep you stepping. One, two,
Cheerios!
Racer can go wherever you go. It's a belt that doubles as a racetrack. By using the spring-loaded buckle launcher, you can send the race car speeding down the belt track. Each belt racer sold separately.
Belt Racer. You can take a racetrack wherever you go.
Belt Racer comes with everything you see here, each sold separately. New from Crusan.
We now return to the Incredible Hulk and the Amazing Spider-Man.
Bruce Banner, Betty Ross, and some scientists are introduced to a guy who can supposedly see the future. The scientists take him to the lab to test his premonition.
Just relax.
He sees the Incredible Hulk and Betty Ross crash in a ship. Bruce Banner eventually sees what the boy said is all coming true. And he prevents that from happening. And Bruce Banner saves the day.
The Incredible Hulk and the Amazing Spider-Man will return after these messages.
It's Skidoodle, and you can draw most anything, most anywhere, most anytime, with your Skidoodle. You can stop a drawing in one place, start it again in another. You can make a great design or draw whatever comes to mind. Oh, it's Skidoodle, and you can draw most anything, most anywhere, most anytime, with your Skidoodle.
Skidoodle comes with 12 different design discs from Hasbro.
It's fantastic! The Fantastic Prizes sweepstakes for new Dinky Donut cereal. You can win an Atari video game, a video cassette recorder to use on your own TV, a widescreen TV, or up to $1,000 cash. Inside each specially marked package of new Dinky Donut cereal is a chance to win. Millions will enter, hundreds will win. Details on Dinky Donuts packages or write to Fantastic Prizes Sweepstakes, P.O. Box 4247, Monticello, Minnesota, 55362.
You're a kid, right? Wrong! You're a gorilla being chased by wild warriors. You're playing Amidar, the challenging new home video game. You've outsmarted the warriors and won, right? Wrong! Now you're a paint roller being chased by pigs. Amidar is action-packed like the arcade game and lots of fun. You've won, right? Wrong! You're a gorilla again, only now the game's faster. But you're ready for Amidar, right? Right. From Parker Brothers, the ones to beat.
We now return to the Incredible Hulk and the Amazing Spider-Man.
A daring robbery by two men who leap from the roof of the bank building on hang gliders was foiled today. A clever trap set by the notorious Spider-Man brought the criminals to justice. And now a paid announcement.
This is J. Jonah Jameson, publisher of the Daily Bugle, the crusading newspaper. Spider-Man is a menace. Why else would a grown man run around in a mask and crawl around on walls? Spider-Man!
There we are. Dreams, darling. You too, Dr. Shaw.
Hey, lady, what are you doing? The fire's over here.
Just mind your own business. I know what I'm looking for. And here he comes.
Fire and high winds. Those smoke eaters are gonna need some friendly neighborhood Spidey help.
It's no use. The wind's too strong.
We can't use the ladder. Get out the net.
We can't hold on to it.
One replacement net coming up.
Ta-da! Instant net.
Thanks, Spidey.
Spider-Man, we have a woman and child trapped on the top floor. It's too far to jump.
For them, but not for the old web-slinger.
Right.
This wall is hot. I'll take you down.
Go away. The Daily Bugle says you're a menace.
Lady, please. This isn't a weenie roast. I'm trying to save you. Come on.
Hey, you betcha, Spider-Man. Come on, let's go, huh?
You're welcome. Don't bother to thank me.
Well, you have my thanks, Spidey. I wish I could reward you.
That's cool. We Spider-Men only accept medals on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays anyway.
May I have your autograph, please?
Oh, sure. My pleasure. Now, who should I... Ow! That pen stuck me.
Thanks very much.
Nice going, Spidey.
See ya, webhead.
Hey, didn't somebody want my autograph? Somebody? Anybody?
Get away from there.
Oh, what a mess.
Bradley, wait till you see what I got.
More pictures of Spider-Man, I suppose.
Why, Brad, you're jealous of Spider-Man.
Well, your obsession with Spider-Man is getting dangerous.
Silly, I'm obsessed with you. Look what I have. A piece of Spider-Man's webbing.
Here, quickly, let me examine it before it dissolves. Yes, it's artificial. Just as I thought. Man-made and very sophisticated.
I use my pen with the hidden needle. And look, a precious drop of Spider-Man's blood.
Yes, there are traces of spider elements in his blood. And something more. The final key to unlocking the secret of Spider-Man.
Yes?
Radioactivity.
I almost thought you'd forgotten her lunch date.
Betty, a 10-alarm fire couldn't keep me away.
Oh, it's the Red Cross van. Look, I promised to donate some blood, Peter. It'll just take a minute. Come on, you can do it too.
Wait now, Betty, let's not be too hasty about this.
Don't tell me you're afraid.
No, I don't mind the sight of blood as long as it's not my own.
You are afraid. Well, I'm not.
Bradley, you can't back out now.
But it's such a terrible risk.
Look, every great man of science takes a risk. Think of the rewards. You'll be famous. Your genius will be recognized. You'll have all the money you need for your work. You'll win every award. Perhaps even the Nobel Prize?
The Nobel Prize? It's my dream. But if we fail...
Oh, you're just a coward. If you loved me, you'd do the experiment as you promised.
Penny, don't cry, please. I'll do the experiment.
Parker, quit bothering my secretary.
You see how easy it is? Even Mr. Jameson gave blood.
Then it's the only thing he's given in years.
I heard that.
Uh-oh.
If you want to get paid for your last photos, you go downstairs and donate some blood.
What?
That's right. And don't show your face in here again until you're wearing one of these buttons.
Which spider did you use to make the serum?
That one. The Nephilia clavipes.
Well, what are you waiting for? Do it.
Help me with the next step. We'll start with the low exposure to the radioactivity. Don't let the needle enter this danger zone. I don't mean I'm getting too much radiation.
All right, turn on the machine.
Nothing's happening.
Be patient. Now turn the machine off.
Why, certainly, Brad.
this. I'm a monster.
You're not a monster. You're magnificent.
Yes, I am magnificent. And powerful.
More powerful than Spider-Man.
Spider-Man? Spider-Man? I am Spider-Man!
Well, there's the van. Ought to be a cinch. That was easy. Yep, easy and dishonest. I can't do it. I have a reputation to protect. Even if it is a lousy one.
A spider monster!
A spider man.
Not another one. Help!
That sounds like Jonah. Boy, how'd you get yourself into this mess?
It's your fault! Get me down from here!
My fault?
All you Spider-Man types stick together. Even if he did say he'd be waiting to challenge you.
Another Spider-Man?
Yes?
You're joking.
No!
You're not joking. Two of us? Gee, we'll have to join a union. What's this stuff made of?
You imbecile! Look what you did to my shirt!
Well, think how cool it'll be in the summer. That yellow webbing was a lot stronger than mine. I hope JJ was wrong as usual, but I'd better find this other Spider-Man fast. I'll take my usual shortcut.
Yay!
They call you Spider-Man. What would you call me?
Ugly?
Sarcasm won't help you escape the web of Nephilia, nor will it save you from your fate. Stop struggling, Spider-Man. The web of Nephilia is stronger than your own.
Hey, you wouldn't want to hurt a relative, would you? Why, we're probably second cousins. Third cousins twice removed?
I've had enough of you.
Wouldn't you rather use those on walnuts?
Remember my power, Spider-Man. And stay out of Nephilia's way!
Was it something I said?
He who fights and loses and gets away lives to fight and lose another day. Somehow that's not comforting. Nephilia, a tropical spider found on South Sea Islands, also called the golden spinner, strongest webbing of any spider. The island natives sometimes use it to make bags and fish nets.
You had Spider-Man in your hands and you let him go?
I didn't let him go. I threw him halfway across town.
You let him go, dummy!
No, Penny, dear.
Look at this.
He'll pay for that.
Make them all pay.
How?
Look at the other headline.
Gold shipment coming by armored train.
Gold for the golden spinner.
Yes.
Excuse me, is this the exotic import company?
No, this is a flower shop, and I'm playing with a petunia. Give me a hand, will you?
Yeah, sure. Have you sold any Nephilia spiders lately?
Let's see. Nemesia, Neoscanella. Yes, Nephilia. Sold to Dr. Bradley Shaw. Here's the address.
Mr. Jameson, I have a great story for you.
Where's your button?
Oh, come on. This is important.
I told you not to show your face in here again until you donated blood.
But I don't know where to find...
Out! 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 young kids today. No sense of civic duty. When I was long time no see.
To heck with him. I'll get the story myself.
Help!
Not again. This time I'm tempted to leave him there.
Took you long enough?
Why, J. Jonah Jameson, I didn't know you cared.
Here, the Philia left this for you. I'm not going to be a messenger boy for wall-crawling webheads. Now get me out of here!
The gold shipment.
Save me, blast it! Where are you going?
Don't worry, J.J., I'll save you. Going up!
I get the feeling I'm in the right place, but where's...
Hello, Spider-Man. This tape was activated to play when someone came in the window. I knew you'd find us eventually, so we have gone. Somewhere. Until tomorrow, when we steal the gold. I dare you to stop us.
Have I got problems? Let's see. First... how do I donate my radioactive blood so Jonah will pay me? This serum will do it. But if I take it, I won't be Spider-Man anymore. And no matter what Jonah thinks, the world is better off with Spider-Man around. Which brings me to problem number two. Nephilia. I have to stop him. Which means I have to find a way to overcome the strength of his web.
The Incredible Hulk and the Amazing Spider-Man will return after these messages.
I'll blow this town to smithereens! Time bombs! Try to get up there in time, Spider-Man!
Watch me cut my web, Goblin!
Watch yourself fall, Silk Slinger!
Stop the bombs in time!
If I don't get you, webhead, my day of Nazis will!
Holy Hannah!
And you're running out of fluid!
Is this more action than even Spider-Man can handle?
Spider-Man, a video game from Parker Brothers, the ones to beat.
Know what we like best about your kingdom of half?
Has to be the half-day school.
This is even better.
Then it's Halfsies, my crunchy, sweet new corn and rice cereal.
But half the sugar of most sugar-coated cereals.
How does it taste so sweet?
That's my secret. It's Legree. Now what?
Half a car.
I'm halfway there.
Half a bridge.
Whoa!
Nice work, kids. New Halfsies are a crunchy, sweet part of this balanced breakfast.
We now return to The Incredible Hulk and The Amazing Spider-Man.
Talk with your mouth full.
Dr. Shaw, I don't want to fight you.
I am Nephilia.
Let me help you.
Destroy him!
I told you to stay out of my way! Your webbing fails you. What's happening?
I found a solvent for your webbing, Nephi. And now...
That beautiful gold, and it all belongs to them! You monster! I'm going to jail, but believe me, I didn't stop loving you because you became a monster. I never loved you at all!
Oh.
Come on, Doc. Let's take you home. This serum could make your blood normal again, but it also could kill you.
I'm dead now.
Spiderman. What are you doing here? What's happened to me?
Don't you remember?
Remember what?
Nothing important, Doc. If you ever need me, just hang a web out the window.
Betty, I don't care how busy he is. I'm getting my money, button or no button.
Yeah! I want to see Jameson, too. He owes me $3 for a button.
He bought the button?
Yeah! Want to buy one?
Told you I didn't want to be disturbed, Miss Brad.
$3, JJ!
Of course. There you go, little man. Now scram. And here's your money, Peter. And a little bonus, too. We don't need to mention this to anyone, right? Right? Right?
The Incredible Hulk and the Amazing Spider-Man will return after these messages.
Just last night, I was lost in the jungle with Pitfall Harry, surrounded by giant scorpions and man-eating crocodiles.
Well, Harry and I just grabbed the van, swung through the trees, and over the tar pits and found the jungle treasure. It was really neat.
If you haven't met Pitfall Harry, you're missing the year's most incredible video game adventure, Pitfall, for the Atari 2600 and Intellivision.
Since I met Pitfall Harry, no other man will do.
Pitfall, designed by David Crane for Activision.
Cocoa Pops, spinning tops, Cocoa Pops, pit stops, snow drops, chocolate flavor, Cocoa Pops, clippity-clops, bunny hops, balloon pops, milk drops on Cocoa Pops. Jack in the Box, Mrs. Mops, Mr. Spock, Keystone Cops, for nothing tops, Kellogg's Cocoa Pops, Kellogg's Cocoa Pops.
We now return to The Incredible Hulk and The Amazing Spider-Man.
Tonight, on the season premiere of Different Strokes, Arnold challenges Willis for the video game title. Then on Silver Spoons, Ricky gets a black eye and a bodyguard. Mr. T of Rocky III guest stars. Now stay tuned as NBC Week continues on this station.
And to end my lineup, it would be Blackstar. For some reason, I liked this when I was a kid. I remember my mom making some pancakes, and Blackstar was on. So it always, them pancakes always bring me back to Blackstar. But I don't know, I'm watched it now that I'm older. It's not that hot, but let's check out that Blackstar.
John Blackstar, astronaut. Is swept through a black hole into an ancient alien universe. Trapped on the planet Sagar, Blackstar is rescued by the tiny Trobit people. In turn, he joins their fight for freedom against the cruel overlord. Who rules by the might of the Power Star. The Power Star is split into the Power Sword and the Star Sword. And so, with Star Sword in hand, Blackstar, together with his allies, sets out to save the planet Sagar. This is his destiny. I am John Blackstar.
Blackstar will return after these messages.
Tough wheels with quick slicks wheels, each sold separately.
Check out the vest. It's quick.
Tough wheels.
It's slick. Here comes the Firebird.
Tough wheels.
Wow, that is quick.
Tough wheels.
A 56 T-Bird, a convertible. Now dig the rig.
Tough wheels.
Golden Fury hauler, a 10-wheeler.
Tough wheels.
Tough wheels.
Tough wheels, Corvette, Firebird, 56 T-Bird, Golden Fury hauler, each sold separately by Kitco.
Are missing from Alphabet.
Nasty McEvil.
Get him!
Alphabet! Alphabet cereal, part of this nutritious breakfast. It's doggone good. Two new Alpha games from Alphabet.
Bump, bump, bump!
Oh no! I spilled Alphie!
You won!
You're doggone right!
One game on each specially marked box of post-Alphabet cereal. Some assembly required.
And now, back to Blackstar.
She is there, Vizier. There in the Temple of the Cave Apes.
But the Cave Apes worship her, my lord. Will they let us take her?
They worship her, but they fear me.
There she is, Overlord. Amber the Sorceress, wrapped in sleep for centuries.
She will lead me to the lost city of Tamborian and the powers of the Ancient Ones.
The Lord, the Cave Apes!
Hold them back! Stand ready, Vizier!
Yeah.
Why are you attacking me?
Cast your spell, Vizier, while my power sword holds her.
Amber, we are your friends. You will lead us to Tamborian and the powers of the Ancient Ones.
Yes, you shall have the secrets of the Ancient Ones.
At last, with such power at my control, Blackstar will be doomed!
Blackstar will return after these messages.
Now there are more great styles in the Fast Ones collection,
like Gravel Grinder, each sold separately,
all with one-of-a-kind Fast Ones plates. You can send 5 proofs of purchase from Fast Ones cars from any 5 states to get this gleaming Fast Ones racer free, plus customizing plates available only through this offer. Details on specially marked packages expires December 31st, 1982. Gravel Grinder. Other Fast Ones racers sold separately. New from Kenner.
How did all these raisins get in Kellogg's Raisin Bran cereal?
I'll show you. Take my hand. Those scooping scoops of raisins come from Kellogg's Raisin Land, where I raise raisins.
Well, then, you
for
see.
Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
For goodness sake.
It only takes a sunny wave of my hand to scoop 2 scoops in every package.
Brilliant.
Thought it was pretty enlightening myself. Kellogg's Raisin Bran, part of this complete breakfast. 2 scoops in Kellogg's Raisin Bran.
And now, back to Blackstar.
Bravo, clone! Now do a monkey bird.
You, Pluto, you better not fool with Balkar's magic. I told you so. Pluto, put that down. That's ice from the Overlord's palace. You're gonna get in trouble.
And I wonder if this planet will ever get back to the peacefulness of ancient times.
That came from Balkar's lab.
What have you done? What did you conjure up with that ice? It's the Overlord's Ice Palace!
Amber, the sorceress. She was my ally centuries ago.
On to Tamborian. The mystic scroll will reveal the powers of the Ancient Ones.
I feel a strange presence. Mara, my friend.
Don't listen to her, Amber. She is your enemy. Your enemy!
Mara is my enemy.
Take them, Amber. Take all of them.
Mara!
excellent Amber. And now to Tamborian.
After you, my friend. As for my enemies, they are well in hand.
Where are we, clone?
Wherever we are, I don't think we're alone. What? What's happening?
Clone!
Why would Amber lead the Overlord to Tamborian?
She must be under his spell.
Yes, and if the Overlord finds the lost scroll of the Ancient Ones, we are all doomed.
Blackstar follows us. This should keep them occupied.
A sandstorm!
It is the Overlord's doing.
It's burying us. Excellent. Now the way is clear to Tamborian. And powers beyond imagination!
Blackstar will return after these messages.
E.T.
My kids are wild about E.T. Now there's a whole collection of E.T. toys.
This one talks.
Boom!
There's Elliot on his bike with E.T. And a spaceship. Here he comes! Aren't these little E.T.'s cute?
Wind this guy up, he walks.
Almost like the real E.T.
My kids really love their E.T. toys. They actually believe E.T. lives in their closet.
The E.T. Toy Collection from LJN.
Thank you.
Catch Lucky! He's got Lucky Charms! They're magically delicious.
What? I'll make a flying carpet. And zoom away with me Lucky Charms, the crunchy old cereal with marshmallow surprises. Pink hearts, yellow moons, orange stars, green clovers, and blue diamonds.
Sound yummy!
Yikes!
Where are your Lucky Charms?
Right here, my friends. They're part of this good, nutritious breakfast.
Brought the Lucky Charms!
They're magically delicious.
They're magically delicious!
And now, back to Black Star.
There's one chance, if I can fuse the sand into a dome. Now, what do we do about the sandstorm?
Balkar, your magic is that of the elements. With my power behind it, we can stop the storm.
Well, I guess we don't need this dome anymore. I'll never get used to having such incredible strength.
I hope you never lose it. Let's go!
I feel dizzy, Overlord. You have tricked me. But now your spell has worn off.
Not for long. You were saying, Amber?
I was saying, I wonder how my guests are enjoying their stay.
Yay!
Looks like we're trapped.
Ah!
Good work, Pulu. Quick thinking.
Well, we're safe from the crystal creature, but we still don't know where we are.
Bravo, Amber. I am impressed by your powers. Even the Flame Mountains cause us no threat.
There will be threat enough when we reach Tamborian. There we must face Sumaro, the Guardian.
Tamborian!
There is the Sanctum of Wisdom. Within it is the Scroll of the Ancients.
Finally, the knowledge of the Ancient Ones is mine!
We must strike together! His power has increased over the centuries! Run!
Tight, you two. This doesn't look like a fun place to visit.
That was worse than some of Riff's cooking.
Tamborian. After all these centuries.
What is that?
Guardian of Tamborian. We must save Amber from him.
This slingshot, Goliath.
Blackstar!
This is our chance. Sumaro will destroy them while we get away.
It is I, your friend, Mara.
No, no, I can't. I must help them.
You fool!
The Overlord!
Back, you rabble!
Blackstar will return after these messages.
Lunchtime!
Lunch!
from Chef Boyardee.
Little aliens and robots.
And flying saucers.
Enriched pasta shaped like us.
Good food for active earthlings.
Hey, great, chicken.
Taste out of this world.
There is intelligent life on Earth.
Cosmic Kids in tomato sauce with meatballs and now chicken flavor.
Good food for active earthlings.
This means welcome to Hawaii, Diggum.
Diggum.
What's that mean?
That means it's time for sugar smacks.
Smack, smack, sugar smacks.
I dig 'em.
Give me a smack, and I'll smack you back.
We dig 'em too.
Fun to eat those puffs of wheat. Kellogg's sugar smacks.
Diggum, what does that mean?
That means my skirt itches.
Kellogg's sugar smacks.
Part of this nutritious breakfast.
Dig 'em.
And now, back to Black Star.
Hands off, Samaro.
Look out!
Gang, cavalry's coming.
Amber, you've got to help me stop Sumaro.
Yes, I will.
Care of Samaro. Now for the Overlord. Let me give you a reading light, Overlord.
For that outworlder! It's out of control! No! No!
The scroll is destroyed. There is still much knowledge here in Tamborian.
True. And I would much rather stay here and learn it than return to the Temple of the Cave Apes.
It's good to know we have another ally in the battle against the Overlord.
But Blackstar, you told us that the volcano...
I know, but I think it'll take more than a volcano to stop the Overlord.
Pullo, in recognition of your bravery and cleverness, I am giving you a token of my esteem. What's gotten into him?
I think it has to do with what he's just gotten out of.
Thank you for spending Saturday morning with me. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'm glad that you was here with me. Next week, we probably go to 1983. I'm just gonna go up the line. So, and this is what I did. What about you? Leave the comments below. Maybe we were similar. And I got another question. Do you think 80s kids had it the best? Let me know. And thank you for coming to the Saturday Morning Experience.